when we take the Shishya Vritti means we accept that we are the disciple. And who is the disciple? Disciple has the responsibility to learn himself. The teacher cannot teach anybody. So don't push the responsibility on the teacher. Sir, try to teach me. So many have come and gone. No, it is our responsibility. Now what is the obstacle that we are not able to learn? Number one, argumentativeness. Number two, asking millions of questions. Don't ask questions. Discover yourself. See? When we ask questions, we create a barrier between the knowledge and the student. See? Many times when some people ask me something, I tell them, if I had to tell, there are two things, no discussion, no argument. You ask me, I'll talk to you, but after I talk, the topic is over for good. No, but Swamiji, shut up. No further discussion. The reason is, when we talk or tell something, if our mind is in tune with absolute peace, the totality, the God's will, and in that mode when you say something, and if the other person creates a hurdle by doubt, suspicion, options, then the power of that Sankalpa Shakti is diluted. But this is what the intellectuals are. Therefore, if I try with the people once, twice, when I come to know, here is an argumenting person, then I run away, boom, no more discussion. See? Shishya Vritti, the fourth important thing is, we go beyond cause and effect. The truth is not because of this, because of that. It is because of the truth everything is. See, friends. And the last and the most important thing. On the spiritual path, the teacher never addresses the question. The teacher addresses the seeker. Question you may ask anything, but the student is never, the question is never addressed. It is the student who is addressed. Because once the student is set right, questions will disappear. Therefore, the Shishya Vritti, this is Acharya Yoni Iha Ityadi Ukta Kramena Shuchir Vidyam Apnoti Yat. Therefore, this is the first step of Brahmacharya, wherein we go to the teacher with that attitude. And this is demonstrated in our Bhagavad Gita by Arjuna's statement. When Arjuna was talking and all kinds of logic, and Bhagavan Krishna did not support his thought. He banged him. Klaibhyam masma gama parthana etatva yupabhadyade. Don't yield the importance. Get up. He was crying, Arjuna was crying. To the crying Arjuna, Bhagavan did say, Beta, never mind, get up, get up. No, give him one. Then only that thought fixation will disappear. See? And yet, what is the truth Bhagavan never told? Simply banged him and left him. And thereafter, in the seventh verse, then Arjuna says, he accepts his state of confusion. Karpanya dosho pahatasva bhavaha pruchyami tvam dharma sammudha chetaha yasreyasyad nishchitam bruhitan me shishyasteham shadhimam tvam prapannam. Because of this, I am completely lost and confused. Please help me. Even then, Bhagavan is quiet. He didn't say anything. So when Arjuna says, Shishyasteham, I am thy disciple, then Bhagavan Krishna started his discourse. So the first step of brahmacharya is approaching a Shrutriya Brahmanishta Acharya and accepting the things in letter and spirit. Number one. Yatha nityam guru vritti guru patnya tatha charet. In the same manner, have the similar kind of reverential attitude towards the wife of the guru if he has one, and also their children. The second aspect of brahmacharya. The third aspect is acharyen atmakrutam vijanan jnatva cha artha bhavitaha asmin iti anena. Then whatever is given to the student by the teacher, one should always remember with reverence and gratitude that this teacher alone has changed my life. Earlier what I was, with that reverential attitude, when one listens, one is benefited. Not with the argumentative attitude. This is the third step of the brahmacharya. And fourth is, acharyaya priyam kuryat pranairapi dhanairapi karmana manasa vata vacha chaturtha pada ucchate. The fourth stage of brahmacharya is, the teacher is served by all means. The karmana, manasa, vacha, priyam, dhana, pranehi, ityadi, by all means. Up to here we have seen in yesterday's talk. Now, these four things, as we have seen, they should be properly understood. If you look at the guru as only a physical entity sitting outside, then we have not understood the principle of Guru. See? We simply chant the mantra, Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Deva Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Sri Gurave Nama, Dakshina Rakho. This is what they do. And while chanting, why they chant in this note, in this tone, I never understood. You will see also when they chant this Nakarmana na Prajayadhane, na, they are chanting in a very melodious Nakarmana na Prajayadhane. So the meaning of Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu has to be properly understood. See, there is one shloka which you all know. Mukam karoti vachalam pangum langayate girim yat krupatam ham vande. See, mukam karoti vachalam. The one who is dumb, by God's grace, he can become an eloquent speaker. This is one meaning. Mukam vachalam karoti. According to Sanskrit language, it can be other way also. Vachalam mukam karoti. The one who is a talkative, he can even stop your talk and once for all. In the same manner, when it is said Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, it means Brahmaji alone comes in our life in the form of the Guru. See, don't get lost in a person or a personality. Our scriptures talk about principle. Therefore, there is not one book, one prophet or one guru and one no. See? No personality. So Brahmaji comes in our life in the form of the guru. Guru Vishnu, Vishnuji comes in our life in the form of the guru. Then Maheshwara comes in the form of the guru, and in fact, Parabrahma, Paramatma alone is our essential guru. This is the meaning. Now, how this Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, they come in the form of the Guru? First principle. The ocean can become the waves, the wave can never become the ocean. When the wave tries to become ocean, it disappears in the ocean. In the same manner, Brahmaji can become Guru. Guru cannot become Brahmaji. Then the question is, who is Guru? Be attentive. What is Brahmaji's function? Brahmaji is a creator. The one who creates a seeker in us is the Guru. And who creates the seeker? Our own sankalpa. Sadhu revasya mantavyaha samyak vyavasito hi saha. Once we have decided, enough is enough. Now I have decided to walk the spiritual path. The moment a seeker is born, understand, Guru Tattva is manifesting in our heart. Guru Tattva, not Guru person. Then Guru Vishnu. So Vishnu alone comes in the form of Guru. Who is Vishnu? He is a PWD department head. Who is maintaining, a maintenance in charge. When a seeker is born, that spiritual stamina is necessary. So that because of which we continue to walk the spiritual path, that inner strength, commitment to the cause, that is the Guru manifested in our heart. See, friends. Last time we have seen, otherwise we go for Guru shopping. And then get more confused. That Guru told, you know, you should worship Shiva. But that Guru told, you should worship Vishnu. And that Guru told Ganapati Bappa Maurya. To whom to go? Go to Kali Mata. One more confusion. See, friends. Our commitment to the cause without any compromise is the Guru Tattva in the form of Vishnu Bhagavan. Guru Vishnu. Guru Devo Maheshwara. Maheshwara is the destroyer of all the evils in our life. What are the evils in the life of a seeker? Gross things you know. I am not telling you that. The real evils are three. Alasya, Nidra, Pramad. Laziness. Oh, not now. Nidra, coming to the satsang. In a shambhavi mode. And Pramad. The same mistake is repeated again and again, again and again. See, friends, in our Tripura Rahasya, when Parshuramji happened to meet a great master, he experienced the divine bliss, and he asked, "Sir, what is this I am experiencing?" So you are told, this is Brahmananda, and this is what it is. Once he told. He said, no, explain properly. Second time a question is asked, the student is not worth addressing. In one go, it must happen. And it can happen only under one condition. We are 100% available. There are four types of students. Uttam Adhikari, in one go everything happens. Like we take the thread, apply saliva to it, make it hard, and then take the eye of the needle, and it has not gone. Such a student, he is not qualified. See? Uttam Adhikari, the best is the one. In one go, the things are done. Second is Madhyam Adhikari. The one who understands conveniently whatever is beneficial to him. He takes out only what is suitable for him. See, Guru Maharaj told you should be disciplined, therefore I am scolding you. You are not appointed as a manager of the whole thing. See, number one. Two. The third thing. Third is Adham Adhikari. First was Uttam, second was Madhyam, third was Adham. Adham is the one who doesn't understand anything. There is no difference between him and the chair. Both of them are steady. They are chair persons. Third, Adham Adhikari, useless. And the best category is Adhamadham. The one who understands exactly opposite. Now tell me, where is the Guru? Guru is not outside somewhere. It is in our own heart. So these negativities, if they are destroyed, that means if we are able to conquer alasya nidra pramad, laziness, excessive sleep, and repeating the same mistake again and again, then only Lord Shiva has appeared in our bosom as Guru Maharaj. See, friend, these are the principles, not the personalities. Otherwise, you'll get lost only in this. See? Like the small kids are taught, these subtle concepts cannot be taught to the children. So we take some support. Like suppose the children are to be taught, you know, sums. The children don't understand what is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are only concepts. But the children understand the chocolate. So when the chocolates are brought in the classroom, children are happy. Come on, today we are going to get chocolate. But the teacher is interested in teaching maths, not chocolate. So she emphasizes on the number and chocolate is just a support. So she says, this is, say after me, all the children are ready. Say after me, one chocolate. Say, the children say, one chocolate. See, the importance is shifted. Then the other chocolate is taken. Now this one plus one is equal to two chocolates. The children also say, one plus two chocolates. See, friends, in the same manner, what the teacher is teaching and what we understand is according to our requirement or our training. See, friends. Therefore, Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, don't push any person in the form of a guru, but discover that Guru Tattva in your heart and be attentive. When we are going by a car, the car has helped us to reach the destination, don't we have respect for the car? Although we know the car is not the destination, the car is not the road, yet we are respect. In the same manner, anybody in the universe who has helped us to make us self-oriented, whosoever he or she may be, all of them have manifested in the form of Guru in our heart. Therefore, Dattatreya Bhagwan in Bhagavad Mahapuran had 24 gurus. So, Guru is therefore our ability to learn. If we are not able to learn, even Sakshat Brahmaji comes and teaches us, he will fail. See, friends. Therefore, in the relationship of Guru Shishya, it is the disciple who is important and not the Guru. So here, these four aspects of the Guru are indicated. Now further he tells, we are yet to understand the deep meaning of this. Kalena padam labate tathayam tathaiva padam guru yogatascha utsah yogi rajapadam ruchet shastrena padam cha tato bhiyati. Now these four types of stages are the one through which the student has to go. First, the jignasa, the urgent need, inquiry about the truth is the first step. Then the second comes, this step is successful when we come in contact with the Guru. The third step is when we are practicing the spiritual life with all inspiration, not mechanically, dulbated. Please remember, no meditation is ever repeated. Don't do meditation as a military drill. It is not an action. Many places I have seen, gone to some places, and it's such a funny thing. In one place, I went there and they were teaching, they were having meditation. They said, Swamiji, if you want to come and sit in our meditation, sit. I said, anyway, I had to sit somewhere, I sat there. So, they took the bell. Everybody ready? Yes. Dun, 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 dun. Meditation begin. How long? Till the next bell goes. So what is meditation? Dusri ghanti, dusri ghanti. When the next bell will go, that is the only point of attention. See? That is not meditation. Meditation is not a drill. Meditation must happen. And meditation happens only through contemplation, not by mechanical drill. Mechanically, anything you do, you will lose the charm. Anything you do mechanically. Once I happened to go in one factory, and there were so many laborers, each with one lathe, and his job was to, when the thing come on the conveyor belt, take it, put it there, give one stamp and goes. That's the only job. He has been doing it for last 20 years. So I was talking to him. I said, hey, if I talk to you, will it disturb you? He said, no. I said, how will you do? He said, I can do it without opening the eyes. I am doing it for last 25 years. Perfectly. I said, don't you get bored? He said, bored? Horribly bored. But what is the choice? I had to earn bread. Be attentive. So he was leading a mechanical life without the charm in life. See? Then to get the charm, what they do? When they come home, they start liquid spirituality. Aha! Maja aa gaya. Anything you do mechanically, this is the end. Never lead a mechanical life. Particularly so in meditation. See? Therefore here, the next one is, one has to remain on this path with great inspiration, utsaha. And this one happens by the grace, the last is by the grace of the scriptural studies. These are the four things. Now, ataha kramaha vivikshitaha. Prathamam guru yogataha. First we come in contact with the guru. Second is utsaha. Then buddhi vishesha pradur bhavena. थर्ड एंड फोर्थ इज बुद्धि परिपाकेण शास्त्रेण सह अध्याय भी तत्व विचारेण. तो दीज आर द फोर स्टेजेस. फ्रॉम दिस फोर स्टेजेस लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड. फर्स्ट आई डू नॉट नो, देन गो टू सत्संग एंड लिसन. श्रवणम, द फर्स्ट स्टेज ऑफ ब्रह्मचारी श्रवणम, नॉट पठनम. दिस त्रिपुरा रहस्य, आई वॉज टॉकिंग ऑन दिस इन वन रिट्रीट इन इंडिया. इट वॉज वेरी इंटेन्स रिट्रीट्स वी आर कंडक्टिंग देयर फॉर इयर्स नाउ. ऑल द सीकर्स आर वेरी डेडिकेटेड सिंसियर. सो एवरी डे वी हैव गॉट 3-4 क्लासेस एंड गोज वेरी डीप, वेरी सिस्टमैटिक. So when they wanted to hear, Swamiji, please teach us this Tripura Rahasya, I said, all right, books. So we ordered the books for them. And then they also collected number of publications. One from Ravana Ashram, one from, what you call, internet, one from Varanasi. So many of them studied. And Swamiji, what is this book? Nothing is understood. I said, then we'll drop it, forget about everything. And when we started, oh, it is so simple. Friends, knowledge happens only through Shravan, not by writing notes. There was one person not having sleep at all. And himself doctor. I said, what kind of doctor you are? You don't get sleep. Are you a medical practitioner? No, I am a doctorate, therefore I am doctor. Oh, what is the subject of your doctorate? On sleep. Only problem is I don't get the sleep. By writing notes, nothing happens. You have to be available 100%. See? Therefore, first is Shravanam. And instead of listening, we get lost. What is next? What is it? That book will get realized. And are book chala gaya mai yahi. See, Shravanam, by listening, listen 100%. Nothing else must enter in our mind. First is Shravanam. After the Shravana is done, then comes Mananam, reflection. Because when you hear, there are bound to be some doubts, some kind of confusion. You cannot go in one go straight unless we are Uttam Adhikari. So Shravanam is substantiated by Mananam, where all the possible doubts are erased by reflection. And this Mananam is done at two stages. One, among the students, yourself, you sit together, read together, study together, rather than gossiping together. Only that subject. Tat Chintanam, Tat Kathanam, Anyonyam Tat Prabodhanam, Etat Eka Paratvamcha, Brahma Bhyasa Vidurbudhaha. Wise people say, that alone is the theme, that alone is the discussion, that alone is the purpose, nothing else. That is first stage of reflection Mananam. Second stage of reflection Mananam is, now withdraw yourself and consolidate what you have reflected and you are convinced of. So first, by mutual discussion, possible doubts are erased. Then, by exposing yourself to that knowledge in solitude all by yourself, that doubtless knowledge is converted into conviction. All of us live only convictions. Today, we are convinced that we are the body. Therefore, we live as the body, for the body, on everybody. In the same manner, when we will be convinced that we are someone other than the body. See, friends, then our whole life will change. Then only the next step can come. Kastvam koham kutamayataha. Then the question comes in our mind, if this I is not the body, then who am I? See? And this, who am I, non-stop, continuous pursuit is called as nididhyasan. Nididhyasan is not meditation. Many people translate nididhyasan as meditation. No. See? Nitaram didhyasa is nididhyasanam. See? This is explained in simple words in Ramcharitmanas by Tulsidas ji Maharaj. He says, Kamihi nari piyari jimi lobihi priya jimi dam. Example he gives, like a greedy person, he is thinking of money, money, money all the time. He doesn't think of anything else, only money. So for him, it is not that, you know, I think about money only during office hours. No, after office hours it's lay out. See, friends, for them money is the only theme. In the same manner, nididhyasana means a seeker in the stage of nididhyasana is totally changed. Everything, every experience reveals the truth to him. Then you don't have to search for the truth in the books. Is par kaun sa example batave? No. It comes. Because you are committed to that. See? Therefore, these are the four stages of Brahmacharya. First is Shravanam. Second is discussion among the same kind of students. No arguments. So our doubts are cleared. Then conviction by exposing ourselves to the same. And ultimately, that alone is the pursuit of life, nothing else. When this is practiced, then jnanadinam acharya sannidhane phalasiddhi ityah. Thereafter, it is said that jnanadayo dvadasha yasya rupamanyani changani tathavalancha acharya yogi phalati tijahur brahmartha yogena cha brahmacharyam. It is said, Jnanam jnanadina purvokta dvadasha guna yasya purushasya rupam. We have earlier seen there are 12 aspects of the knowledge. So he who has those 12 aspects of the knowledge fully established in him, and also shadvidha tyagaha and 6 kinds of renunciations. This we have studied. If you don't remember, go back next year, last year's talks. So Jnanadaya dvadasi isya rupam anyani changani cha balam cha, and balam is tad dharma paripadana samarthyam. Therefore, one has to have the stamina. Upanishad says, nayam atma balahi nena labhyah. A person who is sentimental all the time, crying, you know. See, I have been doing puja of this Krishna, and now you say that na tatra chakshur gacchati, na vaag gacchati, then what I am seeing here, you know. Yan manasana manute jena ahur manomatam tadeva brahmatvam viddhi nedam ghanti mupasate. People become sentimental, frustrated. No! Be ruthlessly subjective. Therefore, balam cha, strong enough. And such a person, so he who has got the proper understanding, purification of the mind, then sufficient dispassion, and then the stamina to walk the spiritual path, and finally, acharya yogi, under the shelter and guidance of the acharya, for him only, phalati, this spiritual practice becomes fructifying, not otherwise. Brahmartha yogena cha brahmacharyam, And then only this brahmacharya, that what we have seen, shravan, manan and nididhyasana, this becomes meaningful and fructifying only if we are under the guidance of the teacher Shrutriya Brahmanishtha. See, friends. There is a difference between these two words, guru and acharya. See? Acharya means the one who demonstrates what is said in the scriptures through his own life. He is Acharya. And Acharyavan Purusho Veda, it is said in Chandogya Upanishad. The one who is Acharyavan, he who has studied from the Acharya, Shrutriya Brahmanishtha, he alone knows the reality. Acharya Dvai Vidya Vidita Iti. So Brahmartha Yoga Nitya Brahmacharyam Yaditam Guru Sannidho Shishradi Charam Tad Brahmacharyam. Therefore, all this spiritual practice can be only under the guidance and the umbrella of the Acharya, not otherwise. See, friends, otherwise we get lost in this world. Once I was in Kailash Manas. And I was walking around the Kailash mountain. And there I saw Lord Shiva and Parvati sitting together. So I went and did namaskar. Shiva was in a very different mood. So Parvati Amma asked, what happened? She said, I am worried. You are worried? Why you are worried? I am worried. So many people are coming for here darshan, not one or two, but thousands and thousands and thousands every year from all over India, NRIs, everybody is coming. If all of them become spiritual, how this world will move? Because for running of the world, we require both doctors as well as patients. If there are only doctors, no patient, what the doctors will do? In the same manner, this world is running because of both good and bad people, spiritual and devilish people. But all of them are coming now to this Tirtha Yatra. If all of them will become spiritual, how this world will exist? Therefore, I am worried. I don't know what to do. Parvati Amma said, don't worry, I'll sort it out. She said, what will you do? He said, don't underestimate the woman power. We are empowered. Okay, I don't underestimate, but tell me what will you do? Okay, listen. I will put a virus in their head. Then all of them will form an organization. And once they form an organization, they will forget you and samsara will start. See, friends, remain organized within yourself. Otherwise, the samsara again begins. An average person goes and buys half a kilo of ladies' fingers. And the ashram Babaji's go and buy half a truckload of gents' fingers, carrots. The whole life goes only in maintaining. Paramatma is totally forgotten. See, friends, therefore conviction. Uddhare dātmanātmānam. Wherever we are, be there. Don't have to go to any place. And evolve there. The right place, we are placed by him. If you see the total vegetation in the whole world, every plant is in the right place. See? The pine trees, the devadar ruksha, they are not growing at the sea level. They are growing in the right place. It is the right place for them. In the same manner, for all of us, we have got a right place. Our husband, our wife, our children, our problems, our achievement, our failure, everything is necessary for our evolution. But instead of accepting it and growing where we are, we want to come out of that and go in a small pot and become a bonsai. I am a spiritual. And if somebody does, see, friends, and this can happen only if we really understand the meaning of spiritual life. Our conviction must be lived where we are. So, this Brahmacharya and Shravanmanan Nididhyasan under the shelter of the Acharya is further glorified. Etena Brahmacharyena Deva Devatvam Apnuvan Rishayascha Mahabhaga Brahmacharyena Chabhavan Etena Vasagandharvar Rupar Apsara Surjayan Etena Brahmacharyena Surya Avnaya Jayate. It is by the strength of this Brahmacharya alone all the Devatas have become gods. Now to understand it subjectively, one example I'll give. The Brahmacharya for the, let us say, a tongue, rasana, tongue I mean rasana, the tasting organ. What is the Brahmacharya for the rasana? See? Eating half the quantity that you can eat. Taking one quarter of waters and leaving one quarter for ventilation. This is Brahmacharya for the rasana. This rasana is Deva, Dyotana Devaha. The one who illuminates, the one who experiences, the one who knows is called as God. Etena, by this Brahmacharya alone, our sense organs remain in good condition. So also at a totality level, all the gods. So Rishayascha Mahabhaga Brahmacharyena Cha Abhavan. Even early great rishis, they have become great only because of the strength of this Brahmacharya. Therefore, please understand, Brahmacharya means Shravan Manan Nididhyasan. This is Brahmacharya. This is called as Antaranga Sadhana. See? All other things are necessary. Do karma, do upasana, do puja, puti. But what is the impact that we are seeing? What is the purpose it is done for? So karma is done only for removing the obsessions about likes and dislikes. If that is achieved, then we are on the right track. Similarly, upasana is done only to make our mind available when we study the scriptures. If that mind is not trained to focus on the given topic for a required length of time, that mind is useless. And that is achieved through upasana. And that upasana also gives us inner strength. Because now we are, like in the morning meditation we have seen, that you do this bhavana, that your Guru Maharaj and your beloved God is in your heart, then that Lord is protecting me. There is no question of fear. Confidence develops. If upasana is not leading to the self-confidence, then our upasana is only a mechanical process. See, friends. This we have to be with extreme alertness. See, friends, I tell you how we can change ourselves. First time when I was given this diksha, Gayatri Mantra. So we were told by the Panditji that you have to chant 11 times loudly. It's enough for you. So, if you listen to the Guru, then you are not a disciple. So I didn't listen. Then I thought, why only 11 times? What do you think? I do 108 times. And why loudly? I don't have to show to others. I'll do it in the mind. So I started doing. And then Bill Gates and Steve Jobs came in my life. One window. Om Bhurbhuvasvaha Savitarvarenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yurpa. Other window, I have not washed up with the clothes for last 3 days. Water is too cold. Why don't they give the hot water to wash the clothes? The third window, every day idli, idli, idli. They can't think about anything else. This world has become idli maya. So many windows were simultaneously opened, and when you open too many windows, the speed of your computer goes down, is it not? And this continued not for a day or two, but for almost 6 months. One day it clicked. Hey, what nonsense I am doing. Oh, and then the mind came to know, okay, whenever you do japa, start thinking. Training. Normally the mind is okay. But the moment has to start Gayatri Mantra, all these things will start suddenly. See? Then I said, this is totally rubbish, stop. No more Gayatri Japa. And then, as told loudly, do only 11 times and very slowly, no hurry. So, Om Bhur Bhuvasvaha Tassaviturvarenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhyo Yona Prachodayata. Om Bhur Bhuvasvaha. Slowly, steadily, then the mind becomes disciplined. If this is not understood, and we keep on doing our puja, get up in the morning, finally we go before the Lord and keep on doing our japa, and all the gods are confused. Hey, whom is he calling? Is he calling you? I don't think it's my name. Then the other god, is he calling you? No, not me. Because that mantra has no meaning. This mantra is from which place? See? Therefore, upasana is done for disciplining the mind, which is made available whenever we want, whatever length of period we want, for whatever purpose we want. If this is happening, then upasana is right. But if we do the upasana, oh God, I had to go, hurry, there is no time. Anyway, Om Rupa Sata Sirvan, 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 Om Rupa Sata Sirvan. And finally that Om Bhur Bhuva Svaha Tasvidur Varenya, it becomes a SMS. Om Bhur 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 Bhur. These are the cartoons of upasana. See, friends, don't do that way. Therefore, this brahmacharya is meant for this karma, purity of the mind. And what is purity of the mind? We are prompted by personal likes and dislikes. Instead of that, we should be prompted by what is ought to be done is done, whether we like or we don't like. Like here we are in the morning, 6:30 in the meditation. So if we have come for this purpose, we should be here. But I don't feel getting up early in the morning. Then you are not a seeker, you are a sucker. See, friends, if we cannot do the thing for what we have come, like, here what we have come for? We have come for a purpose. If that purpose in 3 days we are not able to achieve, whole life's purpose we are ugly. See, friends, this is most important. So, Rusheshcha Mahabhaga Brahmacharyena Bhavayan Etineva Sagandharva Rupam Apsarasaha Ajayan. It is only by this brahmacharya alone all these Gandharva is these various singers, divine singers, and also the Apsaras, the most beautiful angels of the heavens. They became beautiful only because of brahmacharya. Really? I will also start. What will you start? Shravan Maran Nididhasana. No, yeah. See, Brahmacharya is commitment to the cause. You are committed, nothing is impossible. Edena Brahmacharyena Surya Avanaya Jayate. It is by this alone the sun is able to release energy for the world. Akankshartasya Sayogat Rasabhedarthinamiva Evam Yetar Samajnaya Tadurbhavam Gata Ime. Now, the Brahmacharya, the practice is the same, but because of the differences in the seekers, the results are different. So, Akankshartasya Sayogat यथा चिंता मन्या नया रस भेदार्थी नाम आकाशांग चार दस ऐसे योगान तत्त्व का आकांक्षितम अर्थम प्रयच्छन्ति व्हाटेवर व्हाटेवर यू डिजायर दैट यू गेट डिजायर प्रिंसिपल इज द सेम बी अटेंटिव डिजायर प्रिंसिपल डिजायर स्ट्रेंथ डिजायर फोर्स इज द सेम वेयर डू यू अप्लाई द डिजायर फोर्स देयर वाज ए पर्सन He went in the desert area, all alone, got lost. Nowhere any chance of getting anything. And he was so frustrated, oh God, I'm going to die over here. And then he saw one tree, oh, very good, one tree there. How come I didn't see that tree? He went there. Because he was all the time thinking about, if there is a tree, at least I can sit below that. A tree appeared there. And he went and said, I wish I get a nice cold glass of water. And a glass of water. Good, he drank it. This is not enough, one more. Okay. Then, lovely South Indian breakfast. Then all the three avatar came. Do you know three avatar, South Indian food? When they make the dough for the first time, batter for the first day, it is called as idli. And yet it is not over. So next day the same batter is used, converted into uttapam. Flattened idli is uttapam. Then still it is left over. The third day it is called as dosha. It is the same rubbish thing, you know. And still something remains. Then the fourth is called as paper dosha. So, that man under that tree, he said, I wish I get good food. And beautiful food came. He enjoyed. And after that, see, everything is happening nicely now. One more thing, a nice bed and comfortable sleep. I'll be exhausted and enjoy. Immediately, bed came and then when everything was happening, I hope there is no bhoot here. He will come and eat me away. Immediately, the bhoot came and ate him away. See, friends, as is our thought, so is our result in life. That is why it is said, don't have negativity in your mind. Be positive. It is possible. Why not? It is possible. Nothing is impossible in life. What is required is the readiness to change oneself. Two things spiritual practice demands. One is readiness to change oneself, and second is the ability to change oneself. Many times we are not aware that we are unwanted in a particular place and yet we hang around. Please remember, where we are unwanted, leave that place immediately. There's no need. See, friends, and we should be ready to change ourselves. When this does not happen, then we feel neglected, we feel, you know, nobody bothers about me, etc. Therefore, according to the seekers, according to their desires, the results of the brahmacharya is different. Therefore, some people study yoga so that they can open a yoga studio. Some people study yoga so they can start a massage parlor. Some people study yoga so they can go and get married to a Korean girl and get settled over there. Yoga is the same. What for? Therefore, all the gods, etc., they have attained this godhood of Sarahood because that is what they are seeking through the Upasana or Brahmacharya. Therefore, friends, the efforts and sincerity with which we lead the worldly life, with the same efforts, with the same sincerity, if you walk the spiritual path, you are guaranteed success in this life. Meaning, the ability, the commitment, we all have. Only thing, the field has to be corrected. You are all successful in life. This has not happened by accident. You have worked for it. So the same sincerity, same commitment, apply in the other field. You will succeed. Therefore, after having said this thing, Nanu evam jnana nishtata yadi jnana seva purushatvam abhavet apidu karmana iti eva ashankah. If this is the result of the knowledge, shravan mani nidhyasana, what about the karma? By karma also the people say that we can attain moksha. Here the teacher answers, antavantaha kshatriyate jayanti lokanjana karmana nirmitena jnane na vidvan teja abheti nityam na vidyeti yanyatha tasya panthaha. So, he kshatriya, O king, Sanat Kumar ji stating Dhritarashtra, those who are engaged in karma, they do get the result, but be attentive, all the results gained through karma are temporary. The rule is, anything that is created must be destroyed. It's a rule of life. Anything which has a beginning will end. See, for example, take a stone and throw it. So, the stone was inert, lying in one place. Now you have taken the stone and your energy is associated with that stone. As a result of that, that borrowed energy made that stone fly through the sky. But how long will it go? Till that energy is associated with the stone. After that, it will fall down. In the same manner, anything that is gained through the karma, yes, you do get, but antavantaha, it is not eternal. Then what happens? Punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam, punarapi janani, jathare shayanam. Again we'll be born, again we die, again we born, again we die, and continue, there is no end to it. Even if you do good karma, go to the heavens, from heaven again you will fall down and come to Melbourne. See, friends, this karma, 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 don't go too much importance. Many people give importance to karma because they have not understood the meaning of karma. It is not a good thing. See? Karma is the grandchild of ignorance. Avidya kama karma. Because I do not know my infinite nature, I consider myself to be finite. Because I do not know the world is nothing but my own extension, therefore there is a sense of otherness about the world. These two factors, a sense of incompleteness and a sense of otherness, creates an uneasy situation. That uneasy situation is called as desire. And once we are under the pressure of the pressure of the desire manifests as karma, as action. Therefore, avidya kama karma. That means, the karma falls in the purview of ignorance, not wisdom. Then what for to do karma? Yoginaha karma kurvanti sangam tyaktva atma shuddhaye. Use this karma for the purification of the mind. And how do we know our mind is purified? mind is purified when there is urge, intense longing to know the truth. When tattva jigyasa, when the urge to know the truth becomes very strong, then understand our mind is pure. But if our mind is still running in this worldly thing, then it is impure mind. Therefore, karma, karma, it is not very good. Don't get lost in that. And second thing, what is karma? Karma is action plus the sense of doership. So all those who are doing karma, be attentive. There cannot be only good karma. There cannot be only bad karma. In this world, everything is existing as pairs. Good, bad. Success, failure. Joy, sorrows. Birth, death. Doctor, patient. It is like that. And therefore, this karma keeps us in this relative world of duality and dualism. So, antavanta kshatriyate jayanti lokanjana karmana nirmitena. But jnanena vidvan tejaha abhyate nityam. But by this knowledge, by this vidya, by this shravan manan vidyasan, one attains the absolute merger in the reality. And na anyatha tasya panthaha. There is no other way. It's the only way. Now this example which I gave you, reflect on this example. When we stand in front of the mirror, our experience, our understanding is different. When a bird stands in front of the mirror, the experience and the interaction of the bird is different. Now when we stand, what happens? We know it is a reflection. And we are maybe we are looking at the reflection, but we are seeing ourselves. Therefore, we don't look at the mirror, we look in the mirror. And in the mirror, we don't see the reflection, we see ourselves. This is our understanding about mirror. But for the bird, whatever is seen in the mirror, that is real. And that is other than me. Dvitiyatvai bhayam bhavati. Therefore, there is a fear of otherness. Therefore, I must go and destroy. And therefore, the bird goes and pecking. And nothing happens to that reflection. Because the reflection is also pecking me. Okay, I'll also peck him. Goes and pecking. Now, to that bird, what karma, what upasana will help to get out of that mess? There's only one way. The bird must come to know that what is seen in the mirror is not real. It is just an appearance. That's all. In the same manner, this world that we are in is merely an appearance. But whole life we do karma, 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 karma. For what? Reflect on this. Thereafter, life will be lived through us. We will not struggle to do this, no this, no this. See, friends, it becomes very simple. Not at all difficult. Therefore, these two principles, karma please do, but attention should be on the purification of the mind. Upasana, puja, poti, japa, sadhana, do. But the purpose is, we discover self-confidence. We are cheerful and happy. We are not demanding anything from the world. But our upasana, our puja is in exchange of this. So we go to the Lord and write an MOU. Memorandum of understanding. Lord, you have got infinite powers. God, yes, I know. So what? You have no desires. I know. Yes. God, yes. I have got infinite desires. I know. But I have no power. I know. Then why not we sign an MOU? Your infinite powers, my infinite desires. Let us invest. So your power is not wasted, my desires are fulfilled. Devotee. See, friend, to whom are we cheating? Therefore, all our gods, Hindu gods, they have got a smile on their face. And they have got this mudra, you know this mudra? This is not Abhaya Hasta. This is enough. How much you are going to ask? And this is not I'm going to give you. Give you one. Enough, enough. Constantly begging, begging, begging. See, what the Lord has given is more than enough for us. But instead of that, we start constantly demanding, begging, and get lost in this world. Therefore, jnanena vidvan tejaha abheti nityam na vidyate yanhi anyata tasya panthaha. There is no other way. This is the only way. Now, hereafter, Dhritarashtra again asked the question. Abhadi shuklamiva lohitamivatha krishna matha arjuna kadravamva yad brahmana pashyati yatra vidvan katharupam atad amrutam aksharam param. Dhritarashtra asked the question. This Brahman that you are talking about, kaisa dikhta hai wo? How it is look like? Is it green, yellow, red, purple? So in reply to that, the teacher explains after the breakfast. Oh.